He joined the New Jersey Air National Guard after 9/11. He served honorably overseas, and he supported President Trump. 42-year-old Capitol Hill police officer Brian Sicknick was killed this week when that manic Trump-supporting mob, whipped into a frenzy by President Trump, his allies, and their election lies, staged a domestic terror attack on the U.S. Capitol. That Trump's lies have led to bloodshed is horrific and distressing, but honestly, not much of a surprise. It feels, in some ways, like the natural, tragic culmination of what so many have been warning about for years. Why do you think so many people have been objecting so vigorously to his spreading of these conspiracy theories since the election? Regular viewers know that we have often discussed the threat of stochastic terrorism posed by the president, his demonization and falsehoods about groups and individuals, which, once injected into the political bloodstream, could result in someone taking a nonspecific cue and acting out with no specific fingerprints, such as the evil domestic terrorists in Charlottesville who committed violence while defending a Confederate monument. They killed Heather Heyer and injured others, thugs and terrorists about whom President Trump equivocated. Or the murderous maniacs who heard the president and others spreading the conspiracy theory that George Soros, a prominent Jewish American, was funding caravans of Latin Americans coming into the U.S. to do harm. They heard that and then they killed Jews at the Tree of Life Synagogue. They heard that and they killed Latinos in El Paso. And Trump kept fueling those fires. Stochastic terrorism. No specific directive. Demagoguery followed by violence. Now, President Trump's fingerprints are far easier to detect today. After 2 months of lies, amplified by sycophants such as House Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy, who said this about President-elect Joe Biden.
Don't know if he'll be president January 20th.
Not to mention Senators Josh Hawley and Ted Cruz. Not to mention MAGA media irresponsibly boosting these deranged conspiracy theories. And then, of course, came the rally, where supporters, already angry about these lies, were whipped into a frenzy.
You'll never take back our country with weakness.
If you're going to be the zero and not the hero, we're coming for you, and we're going to have a good time doing it.
Today is the day American patriots start taking down names and kicking ass.
Let's have trial by combat.
That was followed by this.
When the whole country hates you,
I want you to go home.
We have to go. Let's go.
Get this.
Did no one see this coming? Of course they did. Here's former Governor Rick Perry more than 5 years ago comparing Trump to the Know-Nothing movement of the 1840s, which attacked Irish and German immigrants. They hated Catholics so much, they came to Washington to destroy marble donated from the Pope to build the Washington Monument.
It is wrong. They built nothing. They created nothing. They existed to cast blame and tear down certain institutions, to give outlet to anger. Donald Trump is the modern-day incarnation of the Know-Nothing movement.
And yet, Perry later endorsed Trump and became his energy secretary. But he saw it coming. He warned about it, a violent mob descending upon the Capitol. The MAGA terrorists came into the Capitol and vandalized Congress. They stole computers. This guy has restraints, perhaps planning to take hostages. This guy has a neo-Nazi T-shirt. This one, a Confederate flag. Traitors, one and all. And let us be clear-eyed. After losing the election, President Trump and his team tried to overturn the election results, first legally through courts and election boards, and then not so, by abusing his power, pressuring legislatures, a secretary of state, and even the vice president, telling them to break the law to give him the election. And then finally, after all other options had run out, the president and his team incited intimidation and violence, and 5 people were killed and countless others injured. And it could have been worse. Was it really a surprise to hear these thugs chanting that they wanted to kill Vice President Pence?
Hey, Mike Pence! Hey, Mike Pence! Hey, Mike Pence!
Trump had been lying to his base, telling them that Pence could overturn the election. And it was not until the day before that Pence made clear he had no power to do so. The president all but handed the mob a noose. The ones who committed violence, they're being arrested. But what about those who incited this attempted coup, who remain in our midst? What about those who lied? The 126 House Republicans who signed on to that mendacious lawsuit. The 147 House and Senate Republicans who, even after blood had been shed, supported sedition, supported disenfranchising millions of legal voters because the states went for Biden. Will there be any consequences? Will Kevin McCarthy remain the Republican leader of the House? Are Cruz and Hawley, whose legacies are forever stained by blood, are they just going to be allowed to pick up their committee assignments and try to move on? And what about the President of the United States? Will he be allowed to fly out of Washington on January 19th to spend his days luxuriating on the golf course, spreading more lies through the TV networks that were also part of this treason? What happens to us? What happens to our country if we continue to pretend leaders who played a role in this attempted coup, in this terrorist attack, end up doing just fine with no consequences at all? Will January 6, 2021 be remembered as only the beginning?